preparation of carbonyl compounds. So actually all the reaction that we will be discussing in this video, we already learned in the previous video or chapter. The first one is ozonolysis of alkene. We know that ozone is a powerful oxidizing agent, and the oxidation of alkene with ozone is an example of oxidative cleavage reaction. This involves two steps and in which the equation can be written as follows. And ozonolysis of alkene will produce ketone or aldehyde. Here are a few examples of ozonolysis of alkene that will form ketone or aldehyde. Second reaction we already learned in the benzene chapter, which is Friedel-Crafts acylation. So this involves the acylation of aromatic rings, and the acylating agents are acyl chlorides. Typical Lewis acid catalysts are acids and aluminium trichloride, and the product produced is aromatic ketone. So this is an example of Friedel-Crafts acylation. We also already learned about oxidation of primary alcohol in the previous chapter, in which oxidation of primary alcohol will produce aldehyde by using PCC in CH2Cl2. This is the general reaction for oxidation of primary alcohol. And lastly, oxidation of secondary alcohol will produce ketone. Okay, by using a strong oxidizing agent. So this is the general reaction of oxidation of secondary alcohol by using strong oxidizing agent to form ketone. Now let's take a look at a few examples. Example 1 suggests the step to prepare ethanol from ethen. So kita ada ethen, we want to prepare ethanol. Okay. So ethen is an alkene with molecular formula CH3CH3, and we want to produce ethanol CH3 C double bond or H. Okay, so our starting reagent is ethen, and for alkene, it can undergo only one type of reaction, which is halogenation. So the first step, kita kena buat halogenation reaction. Okay, react with bromine in CH2Cl2 dalam kehadiran UV. So kita akan dapat di sana haloalkene. And then after that, okay, daripada haloalkene itu, kalau kita convert dia menjadi alkohol, okay, dan alkohol itu kita oxidize, maka kita akan dapat di sana. So apa yang kita buat, CH3CH2Br will react with aqueous NaOH dalam keadaan reflux, dan kita akan dapat ethanol. So from ethanol, we oxidize by using mild oxidizing agent, yaitu dengan menggunakan PCC in CH2Cl2, and kita akan dapat ethanol. Example 2 suggests the step to prepare 2-butanone from ethen. So ethen will be our starting material, and we want to prepare 2-butanone from ethen. So ethen punya molecular structure adalah CH3CH3, manakala 2-butanone dia adalah CH3 C double bond O CH2CH3. Okay, so as you can see here, kita punya ethen ada 2 carbon, and then kita punya 2-butanone ada 4 carbon. So along the way, kita akan gunakan Grignard reagent supaya kita boleh tambah bilangan carbon. Okay, next step, kita tahu alkene cuma boleh undergo one type of reaction, in which halogenation. So kita buat halogenation reaction dulu, dan kita akan dapat hasilkan haloalkene. Okay, so from this haloalkene, kita react dia dengan magnesium in dry ether supaya kita boleh hasilkan kita punya Grignard reagent. Okay, oleh sebab kita menghasilkan keton, okay, jadi Grignard reagent kita ini, kita kena tukarkan dia menjadi secondary alcohol. Okay, untuk tukarkan dia jadi secondary alcohol, ini say Grignard reagent, dia kena react dengan etanol, okay, followed by hydrolysis, maka kita akan dapat secondary alcohol iaitu 2-butanol. Next, secondary alcohol kita iaitu 2-butanol tadi, kita akan oxidize dia menggunakan strong oxidizing agent untuk menghasilkan 2-butanol. Next, example 3 suggests the step to prepare ethanol from butane. So meaning to say our starting material is butane and our final product is ethanol. So butane dia CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Okay, we want to produce ethanol yaitu CH3, C double bond, OH. So kalau kita lihat daripada kedua-dua molecular structure ini, buten ada 4 carbon, tapi kita punya etanol ada 2 carbon. Okey, tidak apa, kita tengok dulu. Yang pertama, sebab buten adalah alkene, kita buat halogenation reaction. Kita react dia dengan bromin dalam kehadiran CH2Cl2 dan juga UV untuk menghasilkan haloalkan. So actually, haloalkan itu dia akan ada dua mixture of product, tapi kita akan ambil major product sahaja. So ini adalah major product untuk halogenation reaction tadi. So minor product kita tidak akan tengok ya. And then next, from this haloalkan, okay, kita mau hasilkan aldehyde. So maksudnya kita mau potong dua kita punya haloalkan itu. So, mau potong dua macam mana? Okay, pertama sekali kita kena buat dehydrohalogenation. So, apa yang dehydrohalogenation akan buat? Kita akan remove H dan juga Br dan kita akan hasilkan alkene. Okay, kita akan hasilkan alkene. So, bila kita dapat alkene ini, kita buat ozonolysis, kita akan dapat oxidative bond cleavage. Okay, kita akan potong dua alkene tersebut, maka kita akan dapat aldehyde tu. So, bila kita buat ozonolysis dengan menggunakan ozon followed by zinc with water, so kita akan dapat etanol.